Hi, this is G. V.R. Reddy, lecturer in computer science, J.V.R. Government Degree College, Sattupally. My topic is computer network. Here, first type of computer network. First of all, what is a network? A computer network is a group of computers connected with each other through a transmission medium such as cable, wire or wireless. In this guide, we will discuss the types of computer networks here. Here, network is a group of computers connected with each other through the transmission. What type of transmission or medium? Such as cable, wire, wireless. These are the communication networks. Here we have three types of networks. First one is LAN, second one is MAN. And the third one is WAN. LAN, MAN and VAN. There are mainly these three. LAN full form is Local Area Network. MAN, Metropolitan Area Network. VAN, Wide Area Network. These three are the main computer networks. Here, first one, LAN, LAN. Here, we have a 5 systems here, connected with a Ethernet cable to all systems connected with Ethernet cable. Select one system as the server. Remaining are the connected system to the servers. Here, the LAN local area network only connected with the cable. Here, LAN used in a particular small places like school campus. Within the campus, within the premises, the LAN can be used. Here, for example, in a schools or colleges, in a bank, in a supermarket, whatever it may be, in a small business areas or small areas, LAN can be used. In a LAN, the communication network is used as only cables. Here, the local area network is a group of computers connected with each other, small place such as school, hospitals, airport, like that, apartments, like that. Second one, LAN is a secure basis. There is no outside connection with the local area network. Thus, the data which is shared is safe on the local area network and cannot be accessed outside. Here, LAN is a full secured because why? The outside, there is no outside connection to the LAN. Within the premises, within the particular area, it can be used. There is no access from the outside. So the data is safe here, and there is no chance to share the others, and access the data from the outside is not possible to the LAN. So the data is here very secure. LAN, due to their small size, are considerable faster. Their speed can be range anywhere from 100 to 10 to 100 Mbps here. Here a small size of data, considerable fast, the speed can be very slow here. LAN are not limited to wire connection. There is a new evolution to the LAN. They allow local area network to work on wireless connection also. Here, local area network also, the latest evolution or new evolution, the LAN can allow wireless connection also. Here mainly local area network, here group of computers connected with the small places such as schools, hospitals, like that. LAN can be secured because local area network, the data it is shared in safe local area network and cannot be accessed from outside. Here local area network can be used as wireless connection also. The next one is metropolitan area network. Here where the metropolitan area network will be used, in a metropolitan cities or a big cities, we have a more than 2 or 3 branches in a different place in a single city. The metropolitan area network can be used, the particular identified same or same branches or same collaborations can be used this WAN. In the wide area network is connected with Ethernet cable or optical cable or wireless also. It is also safe, the data, because a limited person can be accessed in this data. The outside data, outsiders cannot be used this network. Here a MAN network covers large area by connecting LAN to the large network of computers. Here a LAN area network connects with a MAN area network connect with the LAN. Here in metropolitan area network, various local area networks are connected with each other through telephonic lines. The size of the metropolitan area network is larger than the LAN and smaller than the WAN. WAN is wide area network. Next topic is the WAN. A MAN covers the large area of the city or town. Here in a, see in the figure, we have a MAN connection, MAN to hospital LAN, school LAN, factory LAN and college LAN. Here MANs connect with the 4 particular LANs. In the LAN connection, we have a hospital LAN and school LAN and college LAN and factory LAN. Here hospital LAN can be accessed within the hospital and the same college LAN will be accessed the particular college LAN. The MAN can be accessed the total number of metropolitan area. It is used to access the within the city or within the particular area, within the town also. Then next one is the wide area network. Wide area network is provides a long distance transmission of data. The size of van is larger than the land and man. A van can covers countries over the whole world. Internet connection is an example of van. Other example van are mobile broadband connections such as 3G and 4G. Here we see the LAN 1, LAN 2, LAN 3 and MAN 1, MAN 2, MAN 3. The wide area network connected with the MAN or LAN. The wide area network is nothing but the internet collection. The wide area network will be accessed. The wide area network will connected with the LAN and MAN. It is a big area. For example, broadband connection of such as 3G and 4G. Advantages of the MAN. One of the main advantages of MAN is to maintain the backup and store the data in the local system or everything in the stores in the online and the data center, where we can access the data through WAN. Here, centralized infrastructure here. There is a main advantage is there is no need of backup in the local area network. Everything can be stored in a data center. Then from where we can access the data through WAN. So here centralized infrastructure is available in the WAN. And the privacy, we can set up the WAN in such a way. It is encrypted the data that we share online. That way the data is secure and minimizes the risk of unauthorized access. Here we have two advantages in the WAN. Centralized infrastructure and privacy. Centralized infrastructure means there is no need to store the data in the local devices. The total data stored in the online on the data center. If you want any data, we can access from the data center through WAN. Privacy, we can set up the WAN in such a way that encrypts the data. You can share the online to the data. The data is secured and minimize the risk of the unauthorized accessing. The main advantage is unauthorized accessing, that is the privacy. Increase the brand width. With the WAN, we got a choose the brand width based on the need. A large organization, we have a larger brand width that can carry large amount of data transfer and efficiently. And next one, area. A van can cover a large area of or even a whole world through internet connection. Thus, we can connect with the persons in another country through van. Such is not possible is the type of computer. Not possible, the computer network is available. Here we see the wide area network here. Wide area network is connected with the LAN and MAN. It is long distance transmission data throughout world. One of the main advantages is there is no need to store the data. It stores the data center. We can access from the data center. Privacy. Next one is the privacy. Such a data is encrypts the data and shares through the online. It is data is very secured. Minimize the risk of the unauthorized accessing. Increase the brand width. It is a larger organization can have larger brand width, can carry large amount of data faster and efficiently. Yeah, WAN can cover, next one is the area, cover whole world. Internet connection does the connect with the person to another person. If the LAN is not available, there is no possible to connect with one person to another person in the total world. Then next topic is network devices. Here network devices are, we see here bridge, hub A, hub B, switch 1, switch 2, and router. Here from router to connect with the switches to hub, hub to systems, or bridge to systems. But suppose we connect a router through directly system also, but a router can access, there is a limited ports in the router. There is no possible to connect with more than 3 or 4 systems. It is not possible to connect with the routers because there is no switches, sockets to the routers. Here, network devices, first one is the repeater. Repeater operates at the physical layer. Its job is to regenerate a signal over the same network before the signal becomes too weak or corrupted. So extend the length of which the signal can be transmitted over the same network. An important point to be noted, repeaters is the, they do not amplify the signal. When the signal becomes weak, they can, the signal bit to bit, and regenerate it the original length, original strength. It is a two port device. Repeater is the two port device. It is a operator of physical layer. Important point to note that repeaters also, that is, do not amplify the signals. When the signal becomes weak, they copy the signal bit by bit and regenerate it on the original strength. And the next one is the hub. Hub is a basically a multi-ported repeater. A hub connects multiple wires coming from different branches. The connector is star topology. will connect different stations, hubs connected with filter data. So that the data packets are sent to the all connected devices, in the other words, collision domains of all hosts connected through the hub remains one. Also, they do not have intelligence to find out best path of the data packets, lead to inefficiency and wastage. Types of hub. There is active hub. There are the hubs which have their own power supply and can clean, boost and relay the signal along with the network. It serves both an repeater as well as the wiring center. Used to extend the maximum distance between the nodes. Passive hub. There are the hubs which collected wiring from the nodes and power supply from the active hub. The hub relay signals onto the network. Without cleaning and boosting them, cannot be used to extend the distance between the nodes. We have two hubs, active hub and passive hub here. The next one, third one, is the bridge. A bridge operator at the data link layer. Bridge is a repeater with add on the functionalities of filtering connect by reading the MAC address of source and destination. It is also used for interconnecting two LANs working on the same protocol. It was the single input and single output port. Thus making of the it as a two port devices. Type of bridge. Here transparent bridge and source routing bridge. There are the bridge which is the stations are completely unaware the bridge extends, that is whether or not bridge added in the delayed from the network. In the bridge, rotor operations is the performed by the source station and the frame specify which rotor as follows. The heart can be discovered frame by sending a special frame collector discovery frame which spreads through the entire network using the possible path to destination. This is the source routing bridge. Fourth one is a switch. A switch is a multi-port bridge which is a buffer and a design that the boost its efficiency. A large number of ports imply less traffic and performance. A switch is a data link layer device. The switch can perform error checking before forwarding data. That makes it very efficient as it does not forward packets that have errors and forward good packets selectively to correct port only. In other words, switch device collision domain of host, but broadcast domain remains same. Next one is a router. A rotor is a device, it is important to device is a rotor. Rotor is a device, link a switch, the rotor data mainly networks layer device. Rotor normally connects LAN and MAN together. We have dynamically updated routing tables based on the which they make decisions on routing the data packets. Rotor divide broadcast domain of host connected through it. Here we see the figure. Here we have a router and switch connected with router connected switches connected with router and the hubs connected with the switches. and the systems connected with the hub, and the bridge also connected with the hub. Here gateway. A gateway is the same suggest in a passage to connect two network together that may work upon different networking models. They basically work on the messenger against the take the data from the system, interrupt and transfer into the another system. Gateways also collected protocols, converts the converter and can operate at any network layer. Gateways are generally more complex than the switch or router. Router is the better than the gateways. Router, yeah, the seventh one, last one is the router. It is also known as the bridging router. It is a device which combines feature of the both bridge and router. It can work either at the data link layer or a network layer, working as a router. It is capable of routing packets across networks and working as bridge. It is capable of filtering local area network traffic also.
We've seen LAN, MAN and WAN networks and network devices. Here we have 7 network devices here. Repeater. First one is the repeater. It is a physical layer. It is a job is to generate the signal over the same network. Before the signal, it is a 2-port devices. This is a repeater. Here hub, this is used for the multiple wires coming from the different branches. That means it is connected with the different devices, connected to the hub. We have a number of ports, multiple wires connected with this hub. This hub connected to the router, and router or otherwise we have no router or internet connection. The hub used for the LAN, MAN. Mainly hub used for the LAN. Here we have a 2 hubs. First one is the active hub, second one is the positive hub. Here we have a bridge. It is a data link layer. It is also a repeater. It is interconnectivity to the LANs. This is also a 2-port device. Bridge is also a 2-port device. We have a 2 types in bridge. Transparent bridge, source routing bridges, and then switch. It is used to connect the boosting the efficiency. Main, it is used for internet connectivity. In this, use it to connect the domains of hosts. Routers is a device like a switch. The router data packets based on the their IP address. Here routers are used to identify the IP addresses, and the data can be sent to the through the router through packets. Router is a mainly based on the network devices. Layer device, router connected to the LAN, WAN, and together it is a dynamically updating router which they make decision or routing the data packets. Then this is the image for router, switches, and hub and bridge here. And the next one is the gateway. Gateway, as the name suggests, is a package to the connect to network to the that may work upon different networking models. Next one is the router. It is also known as the bridging router. It is a device which combines the feature of both bridge and router. It can work either at data link layer or network layers. It is a capable of filtering local area network traffic. Your gateway also called protocol converts and can be operate at any network layer. Gateways are more complex than switch or router. These devices are used in different types, different places for different usage. These are the components, devices of the network. These are the network devices. Today we seen the network and network devices. Thank you.